समपेतमपेतकृत्यम् द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया सर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नय माम चरणं भक्त्या विहीना अपराधलक्ष्यै चेत्तास्तु कामानि तरङ्गम् कृपामयी त्वं शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं बहुत दूर हो गया सो फार We have begun bhakti, uttama bhakti. And in continuation of this, we have discussed about, explained about ādo śraddhā tato sādhu sama ata bhajan kriya tato anartha nivritti tato nishtha and tato ruchi atman. Now, the subject which is coming very deep and very hot. But I want that you should have some greed to know all this and to follow. And if you have no greed, oh, you are bound to fall down the vishya. Anyone cannot save you. And I see everywhere that if they don't know this subject, asakti and bhava, or they have no taste, and they must. So many thousands coming and going. So I have come for this purpose, by the order of it, my Shiksha Guru and Guru, to give very powerful injections to you, that they will give new life to you. Then we have discussed that there are two kinds of ruchi, vastu vaisishta anapekshini and apekshini. But still, that vritti of Krishna seva vritti is there, shraddha is there, nishtha is there, ruchi is there. They are not immersed. They will be in their stage, but even they will be transferred into ruchi, asakti, bhav, prem, sneha, man. What I told? Clear? Perhaps not clear. You, clearly, what I told. You understood? Not fully. I told.
Hare Krishna. So Srila Gurudev explained just now. We are discussing.
If you are not understanding very high deep subject, so you can ask those who want to know.
About Adau Shraddha Tata Sadhu Sangha, about this slok, today Gurudev want to discuss about very deep thing, asakti. Just like in the material world, Srila Kaviraj Goswami explained, like sugar cane, after that there is juice, after that transformation, molasses, than sugar. When sugar is there is no presence of sugar cane or juice. But in the spiritual life, when you are doing bhajan, your shraddha is still there, the propensity to serve Krishna, that Krishna Seva Vasana is still there, and moreover, bhajan kriya is there, sadhu sangha is there, steadiness also there, ruchi of taste also there, then when the taste will be mature, then it will transfer into asakti or attachment. But previous will be present there, still including in asakti. Anything to understand? You?
Yes.
What?
So all the prior stages
all
are also
the stages,
present.
Previous stages.
Fully present in asakti, not like exactly the example of the sugar cane juice where they have been gone.
Like sugar cane juice, it can be transferred into gur. Gur can be transferred into sugar. Sugar to be sitotpal. But previously a stage will go.
Disappear.
But bhakti is transcendental. And all the stages of this bhakti are transcendental. They will be there in former form. But even transforming. Mm-hmm. Then, if that ruchi taste is now paripakva,
mature.
Then it will transfer in asakti. Asakti means?
Attachment.
Then you cannot be. Cannot you be without asakti? Always doing kirtan, smaran, and chanting, hearing Hari Katha, you have more asakti. Without that, you will be mad. So this is very high class of. These are of two kinds. What? Taste in ruchi, in sadhan bhajan. And taste in bhajaniya, worshipable. Without hearing Hari Katha, without chanting, without remembering, no one to tell that, oh, why you are not doing it? Always in it. How? Evaṁ brata svapriya nāma kṛtya jātā nurāgo jita chutta vachyai hasotta thorodati akhyāyati mityati lokavāyya. Always. They are mad. Like Sukhe Goswami, like others, Narad Goswami. Everywhere. What doing? Taking his vina. And what doing? Narada Muni Bajaya Vina Radhika Manana Narada Muni Bajaya Vina Radhika Manana. Like this always. Radhika Ramana, Radhika. If Krishna and Radhika will hear, oh, they will also be mad. And for why? Oh, Krishna lips and Radhika lips, where his devotees are singing. Naham tashthami vaikunta. Naham nirdayecha madhbhakta jatra gayanti tatra tishthamira. If he will do like that, oh, Krishna is bound to come and to hear. So first in bhajan, and then what? And then bhajaniya who? Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Nityananda Prabhu. Bhajaniya will come. It will be transferred. But yet, so much
attachment
in bhajan, always. And bhajaniya. And then what if they will do? He Radhe Brajadevi ke chalanti. He nanda suno kuta divanne kuta ghoshanta vid sarvatau bhedai mahavivalau Bande Rupa Sanatana Ramayana Sri Yogopala. Crying bitterly, heart melting. Oh, where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? Where is Radhika? Oh, Radhika, where you are? Oh, Lalite Vishakhe, where you are? Like this, they will be mad. Like Rupa Sanatana, Ramayana. You can hear, but your goal is this. I'm telling all these things that you should decide your goal. Without goal, nothing is there. So you should make very strongly this will. So, this asakti stage is very confidential and very gambhir. But wonderful life. He was like mad always. And what telling? What Radhika told? Ai dina dayadrana mathura na sakada valokyase hridayam tadaloka paparam daita bhramyate. Oh Krishna. Oh dina dayadrana. You are but embodiment of mercy, ocean of mercy. But now I am telling that you have gone to Mathura and you are with the wives of young Jadava. And here Radhika is with weeping and becoming mad. Oh, if you will delay one day even on and we will return to Vrindavan, you will see that Radhika is not. Nothing is there. Please come. I deena dayar. Nath, hey Mathuranath. Oh, you were Brajanath, but now what you have become?
Mathuranath.
Please come to return back. Why? Why? To please Gopi? No. What? Gopi are what telling? Oh, there is none to serve you like us. For service, they are weeping. Kadava Rukta Se Hridayam. Oh, I'm not seeing you. At once he said. He Krishna He Chapala He Karunai Kasendho. He Daita He Bhuvanai Kavandho. He Krishna He Chapala He Karunai. He Nath He Ramana. Nainabhiram, ha-ha-kadam, like Srimati Radhika was weeping for Krishna. Ha-nath, ha-ramad, prishta, kvasi, kvasi, mahat, dhyashrasti, kripanaya, mesh, sakhe, sannidhi. So we should try to remember all these things. If you are not developing your Krishna concept, no rush will come and rush will be stopped and you think over always, what, how, where I should marry, where I should be sense gratification, and only this idea will come. And when you will chanting and weeping like this, oh, this I have invited you all for these things, that some great should come. I'm not invited you all that you should come, I will fix your marriage and I will do your marriage. Never. So don't come if this wish to select any boyfriend or girlfriend. But I see this idea. So try to give up and chant and remember. I know that when you are in the womb of your mother, you have promised that when we will go to this land, we will always chant, nothing doing at all. And what is becoming? Oh, quite aborted. We are engaged in services, working, making money, sense gratification, and so many things. So I have come to remember.
remind you all that for this purpose, Krishna has sent, not due to your past activities. Why? Your activities are not so that you should come as a human, but out of mercy, because he is ocean of mercy, he has given this form of human to all. Nothing to do anything else. Has Narad anything? Any position? Sukadeva Goswami? Even not. No Langoti, nothing. Huh? Nothing. No. What? Anything for management after whom? After me, who will come in my Guru Parampara? Nothing. No arrangement, nothing, no bad management. So I request you to, oh, what? Develop your Krishna consciousness. For this I have invited you all. I remember, what? My Shiksha Guru, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, in his last moment, he gave many strong injections. That you should keep this injection. And where needed, you should give this powerful injection to all, especially my disciples. I'm very happy that all are coming. And I will give it without any cost. Without cost. Always available to me. You can come and give. Oh, no. No cost. No fee for injecting also. Injection and... But don't fear. I see, oh, some are fearful for that. Oh, Maharaj will inject me. And he will tell that you should be golden hair. So don't fear also. Now, I told you two kinds of asana. Now you should have this goal. Anyhow, my goal is to obtain ruchi and asana. And if you will be matured on this, then all very class of Shuddha Sattva, that is Bhava Arati, will bound to come. It will come. Must come. And what is this? What is this? One is the mercy of Krishna, or his associates, or Srimati Radhika herself. That mood will come. There is no other means. No other way. They will come. There are two things to understand. That we have heard that in Swati Nakshatra, constellation of Swati, rain comes. And that water goes in a banana tree and it becomes camphor automatically in the head of elephants and it becomes mukta. Gajamukta what? Pulse. And if it goes in the hips of cows, gorochana, very precious, very costly thing. And when it goes in the western cells, and it becomes pulse, very valuable, more than kahinur hira, and snake hoof, then money. And bamboo, bansalocha. No? So, someone has idea that by association you can come by in Dasharas, Santaras, Sakharas, Vatsalaras and Madhuras. And it can be changed. But you should have a strong faith that they cannot be changed. What is in your constitutional form. There is something rash in your constitutional form, either Basel, Sutra, Basel, or one of them, there must be something. But now it is covered with Maya. I have to come to help you to remove that Maya. So, there is something in the constitutional form of Jiva. They have some many things, but not
manifested.
Not manifested. Not manifested. Like, by any example you can know, oh, there is Ganga Nadi, flowing very gently, very powerful water, you know. And on this both side of Ganges, very fertile land, very fertile land. So you planted mango seed,
tamarind,
jackfruit, or thorn tree,
bubble,
and so many trees. Same water is given. Same air is there. Same sun is giving light. Same
gardener
is watering. Everything is the same. But why mango tree gets mango? Why bubble tree gets thorns? Why jackfruit like jackfruit? Why not coming the same thing in all seeds? So we are like place, Ganges water, like all these things. And if, so many kinds of devotees of Sakkaras, Vatsalaras, Madhuras, you are in association of them, and they are here making here your katha, Krishna katha. So fruit will not come in one way, like mango, jackfruit, tamarind, and others, coming from their own seeds. So we have something in your constitutional form, any of these five rasas. So if there is a association of that sadhu is of dasyaras, after dasyaras he can help. If a devotee, high degree, Mahabhagavat or Bhagavat, he is of sakharas, he can help you up to sakharas. He cannot help you in madhuras. And if any devotees are madhuras, he can help all. But in the end he will give what you have in your constitutional form. He cannot change. Never and never. So both is needed. One thing more to understand. This high class of Shuddha Swastha, we will define that what is Shuddha Sattva. Coming from home by the devotees who are now matured and they have received the prem, sneh, man, pranay in Golok Vrindavan, Krishna or Mahaprabhu, like Rup Manjari, Gati Manjari, in the form of Rup Goswami Sanatana. This Shuddha Swastha always in the constitutional form of associates of Krishna Chandra Radhika. That is, they are called Ragatmik Jan. Ragatmik associates of Radha and Krishna. And from there, through devotees like Raganuga devotees, it will descend in the heart of
What is Shuddha Sattva, Arindra Maharaj? Come on here. Yes, within in one line, Shuddha Sattva Visheshatma.
Om Agnanati Manasa Gyanandana Salakaya Chakshurunvritam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha.
I think you are, I'm telling in very easy language, you are all listening. If not, then you cannot. But all should hear very attentively. Don't give your mind here and there.
Srila Gurudev ordered me to describe briefly the meaning of Shuddha Sattva Visheshatma. This phrase has come from the definition of Bhav Bhakti given by Srila Rupa Goswami Pad in his Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Shuddha Sattva Visheshatma Prema Suryangsu Samyabhak Ruchibe Chitanasunya Kridaso Bhav Uchite. This is the definition of Bhav Bhakti. What is Bhav Bhakti? It's not any kind of material emotion. If we want to know about Shuddha Sattva, we should understand the meaning of the word Sattva. Sattva means existence. This Sattva has different levels. There is Mishra Sattva. First we should know Sattva means existence. After this, Mishra Sattva. Then Shuddha Sattva. Vishuddha Sattva. So Sattva means existence, and Mishra Sattva means when that existence is a manifestation of Sattva, Raja and Tama. As we find in this world, the consciousness of all the jivas is on the platform of Mishra Sattva, because their consciousness is affected by the movements of Rajagun, Tamagun. Gradually, as they rise up, Tadarajastamo Bhava, Kamalo Bhadyaste, Chaitarita, Navidam, Stitam, Sattve, Pasiddhati. As they become free from lust and attachment, these things coming from Tama and Raja, they come to Sattva. That is the pure stage, Shuddha Sattva, pure stage of existence, wherein the modes of material of nature are not manifest. Yet, in the stage of pure existence, there is no perception of the transcendental variety. So the platform in which Krishna, his pastimes, his associates, his transcendental form, qualities and everything is manifest. Sattvam Vishuddham Vasudeva Shabditam Sattvaralambha Parasattva Vishuddha Sattva Govindam Adipurusham Tamam Bhajami. In Srimad Bhagavatam, in Brahma Samhita, it is described that Krishna, his name, form, qualities, pastimes, his abode and all of his associates are of the quality of Vishuddha Sattva, supremely pure existence. In his commentary on Brahma Samhita also, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains that pure existence which is possessed of form, of location, of activities is called Vishuddha Sattva, supremely pure existence. Therefore, this Bhava Bhakti is a phenomena which is of that nature, supremely pure existence. And it has function. In this pure existence, there are two brittis of the Swarup Shakti. One is called Samvit Britti, and one is called Ladini Britti. Samvit Britti means the consciousness or awareness, Sambandha Gyan, knowledge of relation with Krishna. And Ladini Britti is Ananda, Ananda Shakti, joy. When the function of Samvit and Ladini, or Chit and Ananda, are combined together, this is called Bhakti Shakti.
Essence of that.
When the very essence of Samvit and Ladini are combined together, this is called Bhakti, or this is called Bhav. This finds its highest the manifestation, where? In the Maha Bhav of Srimati Radhika. So she is the source of all types of love and affection. In the highest form, it is in Radhika. Therefore, it has been stated, Shuddha Sattva Vishesh Atma. This Bhav Bhakti is Vishesh, a special manifestation of the essence of the Samvit and Radini. It is there in the heart of Raga Vikjan, especially Radhika, and then all the other
all the associates of Radha and Krishna, beginning with Radhika, it is in them. And in them, it is blazing like a sun. But one tiny particle, one ray of their mood, when it descends through Guru Parampara into this world, Shuddha Sattva Visheshatma Prema Surya. Prema Surya means the son of Prema. But Bhav is what? Prema Surya Angsu. One small ray of that Ragatmik Prema descends to this world, Prema Surya Angsu Samyabak, and it is reflected into the heart of the Jiva here. When that touches him, then Ruchibi Chitamasrinya Kridaso Bhava Uchite. The heart of the living entity melts. Just as ice melts and becomes water, so in the same way, the living entity, his heart melts and and it becomes, oh, three types of ruchi. Here Rupa Goswami Pali is explaining. Ruchi bi chitanasrinya. What is that ruchi? That ruchi has been described. This taste comes in the form of three types of abhilas, three types of intense hankering. The first type is called Bhagavat Prapt Abhilas, the intense hankering to attain one's Ishtadev. Hey Rad, hey Braja Devi K. Oh Shimati Radhika, where are you? Oh the Krishna Chandra, where are you? Very intense hankering to attain them. But only to attain them is not enough. The heart will be melting with another intense desire that is called Anukul Abhilas. The intense hankering to render some service to them, which is very, very favorable. What they require at any particular time, which will give them so much happiness. Tambula apana pada madana payodana visaradibi vrindaranya maeswarim pratya yashto shantipya. Prana peshta saki kilade pikilasan kochita bhumika keli bhumishu rupa manjari mukasta dasika sangse Raghunath Das Goswami Pad. He prays, I am taking shelter of Sri Rupa Manjari and those who are in her group. Why? Because from them, this Bhav Bhakti will come. And then the desire, Anukul Abhilas, to render some very favorable service, like Tambul Arpana, preparing Tambul for Radha and Krishna, Pada Madana, massaging their lotus feet when they become fatigued, Payo Dana Abhisaradibi, bringing water, taking Radhika for Abhisar to meet with Krishna in secret place in the forest. So this desire, Anukul Abhilas, means the desire to render Anukul Seva. But oh, not enough. Oh, more melting will come. What is that? That is that ruchi is called Sohard Abhilas. It's not so hard to remember. Try to remember this word. Sohard Abhilas. Sohard has come in Sanskrit from the word Surit. Surit means a friendship. Very intimate and close friendship. What Radhika may not tell to others. Oh, may she tell to me and give me that service that others will not see. So this is called Sohard Abhilas. Not enough to attain one to Ishtadev, not enough only to serve, but to have a very intimate mood of friendship, very close surat. Hearts are very close together. So when these three types of taste, or three types of abhilas, intense hankering, manifest from the heart melts and they come out. So by this verse, Srila Rupa Goswami has indicated two things. Shuddha Sattva Visheshatma, that the vritti of Swarup Shakti will come down from the Nitya Parikars of Radha and Krishna. And when it touches your heart will melt and some abhilas will come out. So that is described in the second part of the verse, Ruchi Bir Cheta Masrinya. So what Srila Gurudev is describing about Swati Nakshatra, in other words, that some power is in the rain of Swati Nakshatra and some power is also in the receptacles of the rain of Swati Nakshatra. So both of these points have been explained in this verse of Srila Rupa Goswami. That something will come from the Nitya Parikars of Radha and Krishna, and something is there in your heart which will come out on the touch of their mood. This is called Bhav Bhakti.
Hearing this, some devotees, they want that this mood should come at once in me. And sometimes they want to expose all these things artificially.
line it is come through that line that we explained, or then real thing will come. Real mood will come. But when that mood is not in you, and you are exposing for others to see on for praise, that they should know that I am in this. If that your mood is not like that, and it has not come from the proper channel to ragatmik and then raganuga to you, and if it is not viseshatma, then what will be? They will be called sahajiya. So I want that you should not be sahajiya. Always follow your adhikar, stay, and do accordingly. Don't expose, don't try. What is coming naturally, then it is okay. With a ganya, with trinadapi slokas that follow, then it is okay. But if you will do artificially anything to show them, no, you will be sahajiya, and after some time you will diminish. So always be careful. There are some symptoms of pure this mood, bhav. And that what? Shanti, abhyakta kalatvam, viraktir, manusunyata, asa bandha, samudhakandha, namudhane, sadharva, asakti, tada, gunakhyane, priti, tad, vasatya, stale, ityad, bhava, sur, bhavang, kurajane. Even a ankur, a sprout of bhava is there in your heart, then these symptoms will come. What? And you should judge whether these symptoms are
sprouting or not.
Even in a smallest kad, autumn light, or not. And we are that a standard of bhakta. We are not in 60 years, 20 years, 50 years, or where we were, we are still there, full of anath. So try to. This sloka is like a barometer of bhakti.
Om Ajnani, Chimirandasya Jnanam Janashalakaya. Chakshurunvilitam yena tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. So Srila Gurudev is enlightening us about the characteristics and the qualities which are naturally exhibited by someone who has come to this stage of development in his bhakti, which is the stage of bhav. So Srila Rupa Goswami has written this verse describing the nine different symptoms that one experiences in this stage. And these, as Gurudev said, these symptoms are manifested naturally and automatically in someone. They are not artificially displayed. So first, it says, kshantir avyarta kalatvam viraktir manushunyata. Kshantir means that he is constantly completely tolerant of all conditions. Nothing can shake him from his constant engagement in the service of Krishna. He is so spontaneously absorbed that any kind of adverse situation cannot shake him at all. So kshantir, avyartha kaladvam, next symptom.
Like Prahlad Maharaj, Haridas Thakur. He was bitten in 22 markets. Prahlad was given poison and so many things. But they were steady. Like that. Shanti, always. Jayatma, samprasiddha. In any
situation.
Oh, they will not be deviated from that.
The next symptom, it tells that this bhav bhakta, he does not want to see that even one single moment of his time goes by without
constantly in engaging in shravam, kirtam, smaram, bandhanam, padasevanam, fully absorbed in tasting and relishing the nectar of Krishna's naam, guna, rupa, lila. This is called avyartha kalatvam. He doesn't want to waste a single moment. Kshantir avyartha kalatvam viraktir mana shunyata. He is completely detached, virakti. He has no attachment to the sense objects of this world. They are completely dead to him. They have no life, no attraction at all. Viraktir mana shunyata.
What virakti
mode? Habili virakti detachment from sense gratification and worldly desire. Any of you? Then how that mood will come? Be ready for this. And if you are not ready, bhakti is so far. So try first all these things. Your whole attachment should be given to Krishna. Nowhere else. Or guru. Or any devotee who is like this. No sense gratification. No worldly attachment. He had no time to think about them. Then this mood is there, otherwise not. Very clearly you should think about this. I have called for these things, that remember. And if there is anything, oh, I have a sword that my Gurudev has given and Swamiji, I will give you that sword and you should cover all your attention.
So the next symptom, mana shunyata. Mana shunyata means that he is completely devoid of any desire for praise and adoration and distinction coming to him from other persons. Just like the verse of Shikshashtakam, which Srila Gurudev quoted, Tridadapi sunichena, Tororapi sahishnuna, Amanina, Manadena, Kirtaniya Sadahari. So here, the devotee has Amanina. He doesn't desire any kind of respect or praise from anyone. His heart is devoid of this desire. And on the contrary, Manadena, he's always giving appropriate respect to all others, seeing that Krishna is residing within their heart. So in the stage of bhav, this quality automatically manifests there. And he has the deepest type of humility, natural humility displayed. Viraktir mana shunyata. Asha bandha samutkanta. Asha bandha means that he has an unbreakable hope, asha, that Krishna will bestow his causeless mercy upon him. This hope is constantly there within his heart. And he knows that Krishna is a causeless ocean of mercy, Karuna Sindhu, and that he is always giving his mercy to all souls who are fallen within this world. So the Bhav Bhakta is constantly praying for the mercy of Krishna, Asha Bandha, Samutkanta.
That, oh Krishna, I must attend Krishna life. I hope you should think like that, that after some time from my sadhan, in this human life, we will attain that love, which is very high, very high. Must I will, because our Guru Bhargava all and others, they have attained this. So why not myself? So I must achieve this hope and more.
Asha bandha sumutkanta. Sumutkanta means that he has a very intense eagerness. Constantly he is desiring that this perfectional stage will be attained by him. Sumutkanta. He's always praying, offering so many prayers from the core of his heart that this stage can be attained by him and he can serve Krishna with praying. So that is the sixth symptom, sumutkanta.
No.
more than this.
He'll think it. When it will come? When it will. Always hankering. This is some of concern. When it will come? Or still I have not nothing. But when it will come? And he will exercise all bhakti limbs, always, and weeping. This is called some of concern. Oh, I must attend, and it will come in due time. So I should be idle. Unsleeping. Oh, this is not good. So samskanta. Namagane?
Namagane sada ruchi. So yesterday we talked about the stage of ruchi, of taste, that the devotee is constantly desiring to taste and relish the nectar of Krishna's name, form, qualities, pastimes. So this is the symptom in the stage of bhav, that nam gane sada ruchi. He always wants to be chanting constantly, 24 hours daily. He wants to be chanting and remembering the holy names of Krishna. His tongue does not want to stop chanting for a single moment. So that is called nam gane sada ruchi. Always he has ruchi and taste for the holy name. Then asaktis tad gunakyane. This means that he has deep attachment for describing all the wonderful qualities, gunakyane, the qualities of Krishna, just like described in Sri Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, that Krishna has 64 transcendental qualities that are manifested in unlimited degrees. So the devotee is very attached to describing these qualities and the transcendental beautiful form and pastimes of Krishna. Asaktis tad gunakyane, pritis tad vasati stale. And the devotee has priti, deep love and affection for all the places where Krishna lived when he manifested his pastimes here within this material world, in the Prakat Dham, in Gokul Dham, how he manifested his divine abode here. So just like the Goswamis and Srila Gurudev described, that they were constantly going here and there in Braj, hey Radhe, Braja Devike, Chalalite, hey Nanda Suno Kutaha, Sri Govardhana Kalpa Pada Patale, Kalindi Vane Kutaha, O Krishna, O Radhe, where are you? Are you on the bank of the Jamuna now? And they go to the bank of the Jamuna searching for Radha and Krishna. Everywhere in Braj they're going to the places where Krishna performed his leelas, Govardhan, going to Varshana Dham and all the different places in Braj Mandala or Navadweep Dham. So in this way, the devotee has very deep attachment and affection for all these places where Krishna performed his pastimes.
But still, the highest place is Vrindavan. And in Vrindavan, Govardhan more. And in Govardhan, Shyam Kund and Radha Kund. And moreover, Krishna always liked to be with his most beloved Srimati Radhika in Radha Kunda. So we should pray that, O Krishna, O Radhika, when you will fulfill my wish, that I will always on the bank of Radha Kunda. Radha Kunda is not anything else from Srimati Radhika herself. No difference at all. In some cases, Radha Kund is more superior than Radhika. We can go and see and take bath, pray there. But where to find to Radhika? Like Krishna has made his whole, he has invested his whole power, whole mercy, beauty, and all pastimes in the names. So names are more powerful than Krishna. So we should try to know. This is the highest. There, when there, my fortune will be, I will be most fortunate to be. If not by body, or then by mind, you should try to be there. So these are the lakshan.
Characteristics.
Symptoms of many things are to know, I will explain how to attain. But in the meantime, oh, you should have a refreshment. And just take his hand. Now you are sleeping. And also, Radhakant Prabhu and Nishant Prabhu, they should be ready. About this?
Yes.
What?
The devotees in Australia want to ask you a question.
Gurudev, an Australian devotee who's listening to our webcast is asking a question. The question is from Subol Krishna Das Prabhu. He says, naturally we have this desire for marriage or material arrangement. Although we want to attain experience of what Srila Gurudev is describing about Krishna consciousness, what can we do?
Or naturally we have no. This comes from where?
Maya.
From the love of Radha and Krishna. Love, actually this is. And we are servant of Radha and Krishna, made servant. So there is it. But you know that reflection, perverted reflection, or quite opposite. So in a positive sense that naturally we have this. But it is quite wrong. Understand? Now?
Thank you.
my sons and daughters. All are qualified, more than me. I want that they should be like that and preach my vision everywhere, especially by this kirtan, this kind of, and by book distribution. You should not think that book distribution is Arup Siddha, Arsang Siddha or anything. Because our whole parampara from beginning, Brahma, he Brahma Sangita and all Vedas from four books. What is that?
Book distribution.
Krishna has desire also for book distribution. Though he in that desire, one desire of the book desire, so he came in Mahaprabhu to distribute.